Hello everyone, welcome back to Bear. I'm Stephanie. Today's video, I have all of my July empties. First, I'm gonna start off with Bath & Body. I finished Nevea's Essentially Enriched Body Lotion. This is almond oil. I only purchased this because Makeup by Shayla always snaps about this lotion. I've actually already purchased another bottle. I like it. I use this one at night before I go to bed, and then I use my cocoa butter one in the morning. This is Lime Culotta After Sun Moisturizer. This helps hold your tan longer. And then this is Ocean Potion Moisturizing Aloe Lotion. So both of these lotions are to extend your tan. This one smells like a creamsicle, but the scents are very faint. So I've had these for several years. If I can't remember when I bought them, it's time to toss them, and I'll go ahead and with the next round, I'll pick up the Ocean Potion and pick up this because this keeps your tan longer and it really gives you a deeper glow. I've noticed in the Hawaiian tropics. This is by It Cosmetics. It's the No Tug Waterproof Gel Eyeliner. Now, I don't know if this is my fault or the fault of the formula, but it's dried out because it really tugs on my skin when I try to use it. Tight lining and using it on the waterline. You put it on, it doesn't smear, it doesn't go anywhere, especially if you wear contacts like I do. I love it. Instead of swiveling up the color, I took it inside of a pencil sharpener to sharpen it, and it's all jagged and ruined. So every time I try to get close to my eye, I can kind of feel that roughness, and I'm like, oh no, I'm not gonna deal with that. But also the formula is, like I said, it's dried out. So it's Estee Lauder's Lash Primer Plus. This is what you put on before your mascara. So it's just the basic primer for your lashes, the white formula and the wand. My favorite lash booster of all time. So far, it's Lancôme's Cils Booster. That's the one I really like the best. This is by Nux Paris. It's just their regular lip balm. It says it has honey and sunflower in it. And I finished this to the knob. I do have a couple more lip balms, so I'm not gonna repurchase this yet. Maybe next year, I'll give it a go. And last is a fragrance. Now, I did a perfume declutter, so I don't have no business buying perfume, but there's something about this scent. This is C by Giorgio Armani. Oh, what it does to me. Let's start doing is keeping just the little sleeve that the samples come in. And this is just to remind me that this is something you really liked. And for birthdays, Christmas, some sort of a special occasion, my family's like, what would you like as far as a fragrance? I can just pull this out and go, you know what? I like this one. And then I leave the bulk for last. Skincare. First up is a cream that I will use until I am 6 feet under. Retin-A. I get this prescribed from my dermatologist. Once you get to be a certain age, it's no longer covered by insurance, but as it gets a damn, I'm still gonna get it. High concentration of vitamin A, smooth skin, wrinkles, helps with acne, dark spots, you name it. I have a couple of toners. Now, first up is Benton. This is a Korean skincare line. Now, this is the Aloe BHA Skin Toner. I've used this probably about five times. I've used it for a couple of years, and I'm kind of over it. I just want to try something else that's either a Japanese or a Korean toner. This is Yes to Grapefruit Correct and Repair. This is our Pore Perfection Toning Mist, and this has vitamin C in it. I mentioned this in my morning skincare routine. I just doubled up on toners just to hurry up and finish this. I'm not going to repurchase. It was just sitting in my bathroom, and I wasn't utilizing it, so utilized it now, used it up. It's not something I'm going to repurchase again. This is L'Oreal 360 Clean. I've talked about this a million times on the channel. Me and my son both use this in the morning. He uses it more than I do for acne control. This is the Thirsty Cleanse by Glam Glow. It's the daily treatment cleanser. $35, $40. It's up there in price, but I kid you not. I even remembered when I purchased this, it was last February when I was in Las Vegas because I had a sample, loved it, went back to Caesars, bought it at the mall, and took it home with me. I love the cleanser that much. What I've done is, now since the top thing kind of fell off, I just barely push down on the spring until it starts to come out, and that's all you need is a tiny amount. And then as it started to get really low, I opened up the cap because I'm always interested to see how much it is. So it's that push up style where the product keeps pushing up. And right when this stopped ending, there is this humongous hole, if you can see that, still stuck in there, that was full of product. So my point is if you use this cleanser, take this off and just scoop out. That's what I did. I just continued to scoop out. I probably had another 2 weeks worth still stuck in there. Make sure you get your money's worth. I just wanted to tell you the time frame because it took me over a year, and what, we're in August now? A year and a half to finish this huge container and definitely open it up, get the rest of the product out. This is worth every penny. This is by C20. It's their vitamin C20%. I already have repurchased another one. This is just my preferred vitamin C because it just has a high concentration of vitamin C, and that's what I want. I want the glow. I want to glow forever like a freshly polished penny the rest of my life, and this will get you there. This is another subscription cleanser that I finished. This is from Avène, I believe that's how you pronounce it, and it's their Cleanance Gel. Now, this is a French brand. I don't know what is in this cleanser. I mean, I used it up, but I mean, I had to keep my eyes shut. One little drop. You want to talk about eyes on fire? And I was with my Clarisson, I'm like, ooh, hurry up, beep, 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 get this off my face. I wanted to use it up. Pass on this. This is another product I'm gonna pass on. Now, this is a face scrub. It's by Acure. This is a brightening facial scrub, another item from a subscription box. I had to cut it and just work from the bottom of the container because every time I would try to get it from the correct way, it would either not come out, and by the time I would shoot it, this big, you know, glob would shoot across the room, or it would not come out at all, and I was over that. Another thing with this scrub is it sticks to your skin even when you just try to use a washcloth to take it off. So I just left it in my shower. I would use it in the shower and then use the pressure wash of the water to really get it off my skin. That alone, I'm not gonna deal with it. It's a good scrub. It gives you a really good, like, get the dead skins off, and my skin is so smooth. But I don't wanna deal with the hassle of cutting from the top and all, no, I'm over it. Liquid Gold, I finished my Liquid Gold. Now, the bottle of the Liquid Gold that was in my morning skincare routine, that I finished, and I picked up the refill size. The refill size is about $4 less than if you repurchase just the bottle. So I just figured get the refill size. It's the same size amount that you would get if you bought the bottle. And I'm already using it. And you already know, if you know me and my skincare, this, I will never stop using another product that goes to the grave with me. This is a Snail Repair Intensive Ampoule. This is from Mizon, another Korean item. I do enjoy this particular version of a serum. I would use this for evening time. It's gonna help correct or repair whatever skin concern you're trying to correct. My skin reacts very well to this particular brand of products, and this will be a repeat purchase for me as well. This is from Peter Lamas. This is their detoxifying citrus C. Oh, this is a facial cleanser. It's not an exfoliator. I would use this in the morning as my face wash, and I do like this. It's not something I'm gonna purchase, but I did enjoy it. And then this is the exfoliating mask. It's like a peel off mask. It's from Hey Honey. It's the Take It Off Exfoliating Honey Peel Off Mask. Now, these I usually get in my boxes with Ipsy. What I would do is I would leave it on for actually a longer period of time than you needed to in the morning. And I just started to rub, and it would start to make the little balls where it would start to peel. And then I just took a washcloth and washed it off, and it just came right off, and my skin is very smooth. But I do have a lot of samples, so just getting through it. I have another serum. This is from Lancome, the Genevieve. Probably a gift with purchase. It's actually a nice anti-aging serum. It has a lot of active ingredients in it. It's not something I'm gonna purchase as far as a full size, but it is very popular in the skin community, and I actually enjoy it when I do use it. Then a mask I finished up. This is from Origins. It's their active charcoal mask, and this is to clear your pores. Charcoal, I really don't need it because I don't have like blackheads or a lot of acne on my skin, but I rotate, I do a mask every night. No, just a way to get rid of it. I'm getting through my math. Purchased a few of these Yes to Cucumbers, Yes to Miracle Oil, Yes to this, Yes to that from the Yes to company. I am never purchasing any of these masks again. I don't know what it was. The first time I put this one on, the cucumber, and I used the spray cucumber, and I don't have a reaction to it. So I don't know what it is with this particular mask, but I put this on my face, and for some reason, I had to peel it right off super quick. It was like vapors were in the air, and my eyes were burning and started to get irritated, and then my skin started to actually feel like itchy. I don't know what it is, and you know what I should do is I should compare the ingredients against the spray. I'll do that after this video. I bought two of these, and both times at night, I had to just rip it right off my face. So I don't know what it is. And then this is Yes to Miracle. It's the Primrose Oil Mud Mask. Now here's something funny with this mask. It says it's a single use. I think it's single use if you plan on putting it from your forehead all the way down to your toes. There's so much product in here. So they need to take that off. It's a mud mask and it's pink. If I can push some up, you know, it's pink. And it has like a floral scent. My problem with this is if you have oily skin or normal skin, I don't even think it says that on there. It doesn't say what type of skin types should use this. This is greasy as yes. I have normal skin and smooth texture. So you put anything on my face, I can feel it like that. It felt like you just threw a bottle of canola oil all over my face. I was like, what the hell is this? Now, if you have dry skin or very dry skin, your skin is gonna eat this up. They should probably put some sort of skin type thing on here so that way you know. Granted, I know it's Primrose Oil, but I just didn't expect it to feel that unbelievably greasy, like cooking oil, like, you know, frying chicken type grease. Depending on your skin type, proceed with caution, as well as their sheet mask on their itty yes to whatever. Proceed with caution. It's Beauty 360. This is actually good. This is the Brightening Radiance mask from CVS. I picked that up. It's small, and you know what I like about this mask? It's a little bit smaller, so it's not all like covering up here on your hair. And well, I mean, I don't need it on my hair because I don't wash my hair every single day. And it's very thin, so it just really sucks to your skin. I really like the CVS brown one. This one I pick up time to time when I go to Target. It's, you know, I love this line, My Zone. So this one is perfect. And then this is the Tony Moly one. This, now red wine is for your pores. So this is going to help if you've got big pores. I don't have big pores, but you know, it doesn't matter. I'm still going to use it. And it worked fine. So I do enjoy that one. I have so many of these in my fridge. That's where I keep my sheet mask. And every time I open my drawer to pull one out, I would see this and I would purposely avoid it because it's so drenched with essence. Problem though is I would feel like I have to sit in bed or I'd have to sit and put a towel all over me because it is just dripping on the sheet. And I don't wanna feel like I'm in a shower, you know, like Pigpen with the cloud and the rain and all that. I don't wanna feel like I'm taking a shower everywhere I go. When I do my mask, since I'm a multitasker, I put it on and I go do stuff around the house, or I go edit, or I go do something. I can't sit still for 30 minutes, 40 minutes with all this liquid dripping down my neck. So I would purposely avoid this. Now I said, when I open the drawer, just use it so that way I can get rid of it and never purchase it again. And that's it. Those are all my empties for the month of July. lots of stuff, I know. And if you have any questions about anything that you've seen, please leave me some comments down below. I love the interaction with you. I do want to thank you for stopping by and watching. I hope you all have a wonderful day or evening. And as always, I'm going to see you in the next video. Bye, everyone.